rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop.
Hey loves, welcome to Vlogmas Day. I have no idea. Okay, so I just decided that I needed to record this video because I'm not going to be able to record it tomorrow. So I didn't check my planner to see what day it is, but I do know that the video is basically how to give back during the holidays. I am so sorry, I look horrible right now. I just came back from school. I had to go help out my mom with some things. I cleaned the house, I got some boba. I'm supposed to work out right after this video so I can shower and then let my hair dry so I can straighten it tomorrow. But basically, I'm just gonna give you guys a couple ideas to how to give back during this holiday season in case you guys want to share, like, you know, the holiday spirit with other people or give it to other people that can't really afford gifts and food during the holiday season. And honestly, everyone has been through something like that. Not everyone, but most of this population has gone through something where they had struggled to get stuff for Christmas or get stuff for like Thanksgiving, food, anything like that. It is completely normal, nothing to be ashamed of. Everyone has gone through it and everyone shouldn't really look down at that. But I'll give you guys a couple ideas and I hope you guys like them. I hope you guys participate in giving back during the holiday season. And well, yeah. Okay, so the first idea, which is kind of more easier for people who are in school, is that most schools do like fundraisers, food drives, or adopt like a family, a kid, or some, or like a couple of families in the district, and they will help them out. So if you guys do want to learn how to help people, they either announce it to the whole school, or you can just go talk to like your principal or your counselor. A lot of them will have that information. Both schools that I have been at currently, like my last high school and this high school, both of them have done fundraisers for people. Okay, so the third idea that I do have is, my daughter's trying to come up here. Okay, so the third idea that I do have is probably contact firefighters, like the fire department stuff. Because I know when I was younger and my family was struggling, I also had cousins and uncles and everybody else who were struggling, and they would do this. They would go and like write your name and your age up in like with the firefighters. And I know that a lot of places, like the fire department, do take donations of toys and stuff like that. So you could probably take toys, and you're supposed to know like the ages, that way they can separate them and like send them to like the separate ages. But do figure out if it's like your firefighters or your police department, the ones who do it. Most cities actually do that, but not many people know. So if you do know that you're economically stable and you do want to give at least a little, I do recommend doing a little bit of those donations. It would help a lot. My family personally does not take from them anymore ever since I was like probably 11, because we don't need to anymore, which is a very good thing. That way the stuff that we could have gotten could go to other kids. And I always try to remember that there's a lot of kids in the world, so don't be greedy, right, Katana? Right. The fourth thing that I do know that you could do is, well, sometimes you do have to contact the animal shelters to figure out if they would like some donations for the pets, because a lot of people do think, oh yeah, let's give some donations to humans, and that's amazing, but sometimes we do forget that there is animal shelters with a bunch of dogs that don't really have much. So it would be nice to get like a couple donations there with, like, you could ask them, oh, what would you guys accept as donations? And they would tell you, oh, well, we would accept these type of toys or these type of things. They would like give you like something, that way you could like try to, you know, help a little. Not every shelter does this, because there is a couple shelters that are economically stable and do provide for themselves. But I do recommend calling shelters, that way you can figure out and, you know, help a little puppy. Katana, say hi. This is my rat. So The fifth thing. Okay, yeah, we're finally in the fifth. Okay, so the fifth thing that I do recommend doing is finding out if you could, like, volunteer in, like, a homeless shelter, something like that, where they will, like, serve food and all of that. Either you could donate to those places, or you could, like, try to volunteer. That way you could, like, feed it to people, and, like, not feed it, will serve it to people. And a lot of people do go to those places so they can get a meal during Christmas, or, like, a little bit before Christmas. I do recommend going. It would be amazing. A lot of people are needed during the volunteering hours, and it's always thankful for people to do that. Also, if you are looking for community hours for college or something like that, like a scholarship college, I do recommend doing that, because it's like, it helps other people, and it also will help yourself with the whole the community hours for college and scholarships. But yeah, I do recommend that. I've actually been wanting to do that for a while. As you guys could go back to my page, you guys do see that I have a, like, spend a day in the city with me. And that day was actually me and a club that I had giving pure products to homeless people. We had raised money for that, and we basically went around Portland and gave a lot of period products, and we actually still had a bunch left. And we met this community who would serve food to people, to homeless people, and give out a couple clothes, and other people would join them and give out stuff. So we left them some of those period products, that way in case they had other women coming through, they would give it to them. And it was pretty helpful, because, you know, period products can be expensive to some people, so we try to make it to just give them out for free, and we raised most of that money ourselves. Actually, yeah, like 100% of that money was raised by, like, ourselves, and then some of it was just used for the fundraiser, the way that we did it. But yeah, okay. Those are the five ways that you guys can help during this holiday season. I hope you guys liked it. Remember that the holiday season is not always about getting gifts or doing stuff like that. It could also be about trying to give to others. Try to give to others as much as possible. If you see a homeless person, try to help them. If you see a homeless dog, try to help them. I personally always try, because of the fact that I have grown up with, like, being used to, like, oh yeah, do you guys need something? Trying to be helpful, but not trying to make them feel bad. Never try to make a homeless person feel bad. It's absolutely horrible. You wouldn't want that for yourself either. Always try to put yourself in the shoes of others, because so many people will be like, oh yeah, if they're homeless, they could just get a job. But it, like, you don't really realize that to get a job, you have to have, like, an apartment or a place to live, because you need an address to get your payments, and most of the payments nowadays are actually digital, so it is getting harder for homeless to get houses. And we do also have to remember that there's a huge percentage of the homeless community that is actually veterans. So if you do say, oh yeah, I love our veterans, try to help those homeless that are veterans because of the emotional damage that they had to go through. Always think about others, mostly during the holiday season and even after the holiday season. Try to help others as much as possible, and I hope you guys like this video. I know it's kind of in the sadder side, but, you know, the holiday seasons are not always happy. Try to help as much as you possibly can. And yeah, okay, that was about it, loves. And the movie for today is probably, what would be a good fit? Santa Buddies. There we go, Santa Buddies. Santa Buddies actually does show a little bit about how you should give to others and stuff. Most Christmas movies do. Like, Santa Buddies, it's such a nice movie. I recommend it so much. Me and my sister watch it every year. But yeah, okay, I hope you guys like this Vlogmas video. That's it. Bye, loves. Say bye, Katana.